When the internet was created, what it did over the last 20, 25 years is it's fundamentally democratized access to information. With the blockchain space, with the blockchain technology that's emerging, what we're seeing is a dramatic change where blockchain has the ability and is actually democratizing innovation itself. If you look at where innovation is happening within the blockchain stack itself, at the protocol layers, at the smart contract layers, even at the ledger storage itself, what you're seeing is a global impact in people's ability to deliver value into these spaces with technology. We're seeing innovation happen in every continent. And what's fascinating is the amount of collaboration and true open source innovation that's happening. So yes, a lot of competitive interests, but at the grassroots level, we're seeing innovation where companies are now being formed by groups of people gathering together, banding and saying, hey, let's go and make change and deliver change in the world. And that's fascinating for us. I think one of the challenges that still exists within the blockchain space is that there hasn't been the emergence of a killer application. And when we started doing our investigation in blockchain and its application in enterprise, we realized that supply chain is an interesting opportunity, an interesting space where there's significant value that can be extracted. So driving more efficiency within a supply chain network, driving more authenticity and efficacy around how data and goods and products and services are actually delivered and moved. And so we looked at this space and recognized that Cisco actually runs one of the most efficient supply chain operations. Let's start there. Let's see if we can actually extract value by adopting the technology for ourselves, not only for us, but also for our ecosystem. And so that becomes a compelling story because now all of a sudden, we're saying as one of the most efficient supply chain operations globally, are we seeing true value being created or true value being extracted? And I would say, yes, we are. We are seeing more transparency, the ability to drive more transparency within our ecosystem, the ability to drive out risk, to drive out some additional cost. And so we're intrinsically an ideal proving ground for the technology. And as we look to the future, you know, how do we take, you know, the experimentation that we're doing and the investigation that we're doing in supply chain space and extend that into other areas as well? As we look at the work that's happening in the supply chain space broadly, when it comes to blockchain, what we're starting to see is the emergence or the transition from supply chain systems, supply chain networks, to almost demand chains. And so that's a compelling argument to say that if you have now a level of visibility and transparency around a supply chain partner's ability to deliver high quality goods, products, and services on time with high yield, could you actually take that data, those events, package them up and create a marketplace? And as a marketplace, now what you've done is you've now created net new opportunity for those suppliers, and at the same time for other suppliers who are in other ecosystems that we may choose to go off and address, we now have a root of trust that we can point back to around the genesis of, you know, high quality, high delivery reputation and leverage that in our own ecosystem. So we can actually accelerate the growth of our ecosystem with these mechanisms.